Dr. Geeta Reddy, Dr. Jignya, Dr. Padmini, and Dr. The entire Amrutha Hospital's team and all the teachers, very good evening to all of you. So first of all, I'd like to apologize for the delay in half an hour. We were supposed to start the session at 5 o'clock, starting half an hour late. So Mrs. Geeta Reddy, I think most of you have heard about her and some of you might have also met her in person. So she is a renowned gynecologist in Karimnagar, and she is also a very good friend of Chairman Sir. So in that regard, when Madam had proposed this idea of having a cancer awareness program, especially in females, so we thought it would be good, and also it will be good to know about these things and also take preventive measures or countermeasures wherever we can. So in this regard, once again, I would like to thank Madam Geeta and Jignya, and also Dr. Padmavati and Dr. Ragani and their entire team for starting this, taking this initiative and starting the program from Paramitha. So they have taken this initiative and they are going to start from today in Paramitha. So you.
Thank you all so much for such a warm welcome. And we are coming for the first time to this school, apart from Dr. Jignya. So really loved your school, the ambience, the neatness, and the friendly way that you are treating your kids. So what we thought, as Rashmita said, I know you all are tired by now. You had a hectic day. But still, I want you to wake up with some of the alarming facts which we are supposed to know. I know you have to go home, transform yourselves from teachers to housewives, to mom, to sister, to friend, everything. But still, see, again, everything happens only when we are healthy. First, let's keep us healthy and spread it to others. So the thing is, the most common cancer in women in India right now is breast carcinoma. Previously it was carcinoma cervix, that is lower part of the body of the uterus. So that was common, but now the most common is carcinoma breast. So every 4 minutes, one person is being diagnosed with carcinoma breast. Can you imagine? Even we ourselves didn't know. When we were going through this literature, we thought, oh, it's high time that actually we are late, but better late than never. Some small measures, taking a vaccine, taking pap smear, it's a small, taking some white discharge over the cervix and smearing it on the slide and send it to the lab, they give us the report. And sometimes colposcopy and HPV testing, that's all. It doesn't cost much. It costs maybe, but not much. It's only a preventive measure. And whereas carcinoma breast, it's not preventable, but when detected early, it's almost cured. You are cured of cancers. Previously, did you hear about cure of the cancer? No. So these days, the more measures we are getting for investigations, the better it is. But only thing is, we need to care for ourselves. And once we know, we need to tell others about this thing. My team, as Rashmita and ma'am is, they are proud of you, they were telling about you all. So likewise, we are also very proud of our team. Dr. Jignya, she initiated this actually. She said, why not we do cancer awareness program? Like, how do we start? When do we start? Then the most friendliest person in Karimnagar, what we thought, oh, Prasad Rao, and he will definitely invite us. So, as she said, today is the first day of our cancer awareness program. So, it's all because of your team efforts. The team that Sir maintains, and And I've been seeing this for the past 30 years or since we came here. I know, we know Prasad sir. So, doctor, then as Rashmita said, she invited this. Then Dr. Jigna, she's very prompt in such things. She did a beautiful presentation. And you all will definitely enjoy this. See this. Don't get scared. Take care of yourselves and take care of your family members and friends. Thank you all so much. And Dr. Beza Khan, Dr. Padmini, and the other lady, she's Dr. Deepi. Deepthi, she's a junior embryologist. Dr. Bezer is senior embryologist. Later on, we'll put a word to you about how Bezer Ghan is important related to cancers. Okay?
Also, thank Dr. Geeta and my whole team to having encouraged me to come here and speak before you. So, I'm sure all of you are aware what we are talking about today. So, before I go into my actual presentation, I would like to tell you all a story. So this story is about my neighbor, Mrs. Sharmila Devi. She is like, you know, towards the end of her 50s, an amazing lady. You know, she's too good at everything. Perfect in her house. She has a little family with two kids, teenage kids, okay? Both of them are extremely good at academics and everything else. And she has a very loving, caring husband. You go to her house, you know, it's always pick and span. And you go to any social gathering, she's always dressed so well. She's perfect. I mean, if you go anytime, she's ready, always greeting you with a smile. So you're such a perfect lady. And suddenly, we get the news that she has breast cancer, stage 4. She had nipple discharge 1 year ago, and she didn't bother to inform anybody. She didn't even share it with her husband. And then, you know, the whole point was, the moral of the story is that you need to know yourself. Okay, don't ignore the smallest thing that happens with your body. We have started this initiative, like from your school, that's learn about cancer, educate. Okay, not only you learn, use it for yourself, educate other people, because you meet so many people. You have your mother, you have your mother-in-law at home, you have your daughters at home. So you got to educate them, and then you change lives. So today I'm here, I hope to change somebody's life today. You are going to change somebody else's life, okay? So this is our initiative of learn, educate, and change. So that's like what madam said, we are not here to scare you, but we are here to make you aware of yourself. So what is cancer? The very word sends shivers to us. Oh God, somebody is having cancer, their future is gone, what's going to happen to their family? All of us think that. So cancer is basically an abnormal, uncontrollable and continuous replication of cells. Okay. So today, we are going to talk of breast and cervical cancer. So as madam said, breast cancer is the most common cancer now in our country, and cervical cancer is the second most common cancer. So cervix, as madam said, is the lower part of the body of the uterus. Okay, next slide. Madam already quoted you the statistics, sad but very true, that one woman dies of cervical cancer every 8 minutes in India. And for every two women who are diagnosed with breast cancer, one of them dies in India. Can you imagine that? In the whole world, every two women who are diagnosed with breast cancer, one of them is dying in India. That it is that common. So we need help. Who's going to do that for us? Who's going to help us? To prevent cancer, to identify the cancer in time, and to fight the cancer. So what do you think is your answer? Who's going to help us? I'm sure all of you will say doctor.
Me.
No? Yeah, right. So the only person who can save you is you yourself. You need to wake up. Okay? So first, let us go into each of these cancers in detail. So what is breast cancer? The breast tissue is composed of, you know, glands, ducts and certain other glands called lymph glands. So if there's cancer cells developing in any of these, there's going to be breast cancer form, and that can spread to these green structures. Can you see?
So I hope I'm not bombarding you too much with a lot of scientific information. So please note down, if you have any doubts, you can clarify, don't hesitate. Okay, there's nothing to shy off at all.
Controllable, we said positive family history, genetic predisposition, and alcohol. Okay, nowadays many girls consume alcohol, so it's not like, you know, we are talking about alcohol, it's only something which men do. It's not true. A lot of girls consume alcohol nowadays. Okay, so how are we going to prevent this? There are ways for screening breast cancer. The first and foremost thing for which I want you people to learn is the breast self-examination. To examine your own breast. The second thing is a clinical breast examination, which the doctor does for you. And if necessary, you go for a mammogram or an ultrasound or an MRI. If you have finished your period, you can go for this breast self-examination. Suppose somebody has already attained menopause, that is, their period has stopped, they can fix up a date in a month and do their examination every month on the same day so that they don't miss it. Okay? No, once you know you have to do an examination, but what will you look for? Okay, in your breast. So you need to look for any painless lump in the breast or in the armpit, in your axilla. Okay, any changes in shape or size. See, there might be some kind of discrepancy in shape of two breasts for many women, which may be normal. Okay, so what I generally ideally suggest is, the first time you want to examine your breast, get it done from a doctor. Get a clinical breast examination done, and subsequently you can do your monthly breast examination on your own. Because by then you know what's normal for you, what's normal with your body. Okay? If there's any kind of nipple retraction, your nipple is retracted, or there's some kind of nipple discharge, like in this picture. Okay, the discharge could be whitish, milkish. Suppose she is not breastfeeding, any white discharge in the nipple is abnormal. Okay? If there is any blood discharge in the nipple, if there is any brownish discharge in the nipple, or pus-like discharge in the nipple. Okay? Any such kind of discharge is abnormal. If there are any changes in the skin texture, okay? Somewhere you may find puckering, somewhere you may find dimpling, okay? All these changes are abnormal. And suppose your breast skin looks like an orange peel. You know, suddenly the whole look of the breast is like an orange peel or it's become red. Okay, and you've started developing pain. So these are abnormal things that you notice in your breast, and you must meet your doctor immediately. So now, how do we go about this breast self-examination? After this session, I'll also be showing you a live video so that you can appreciate it better. So the first thing is that you stand in front of a mirror. Many women also do it during a shower. That's also fine. Do it at your comfort. You know, you may not get privacy in your house because many people are staying. You can also do it while you're having a shower. So if you stand in front of the mirror, first keep your hands on your hips and look at your breast, both the breasts. Look for the changes that I already told you. Turn side to side, okay? And see for any kind of changes in the breast, like lump or any puckering, dimpling, okay? Look for those changes. In your breast, you have to feel your breast. So make a palm of these three fingers, okay? Start from the upper part of your breast. Make small circles and feel your entire breast for any kind of abnormal feeling, like any lump, any nodule, as little as a, you know, if you can feel a small pea-sized nodule also, you have to act immediately, okay? And also feel for the area near your collarbone and your armpits,
Okay, sometimes you may find lumps there also. So you have to feel that area also. So when you do it for one side, okay, then repeat it on the other side also. You can also examine your breast in the lying down position. Okay, lying down position, when you are relaxed, you can feel deeper tissues of your breast. Okay. So when should you begin this screening? Okay, you might be having teenage girls, many of you may have teenage girls in your house. So the question is when to begin this kind of an examination. So believe me, as early as 20 years. Okay, as early as 20 years of age, you have to start this monthly breast self-examination. So don't think only older people are at risk to get cancer. No, even young girls can get cancer. Okay. So if you are in the age group of 20 to 40 years, a 3-yearly breast self clinical examination is a must. So suppose your everything is fine, at least 3 years once you should get an examination done. And after 40 years, you should get it done every year. Every year a breast examination by the doctor is a must. And if required, a yearly mammogram. Suppose you are at high risk, you have a family history or some genetic risk you have to get a mammogram also done every year. Okay, suppose any suspicion, the doctor may suggest you to go for an MRI also. So what should you do apart from your monthly self breast examination? Reduce your weight. If you're overweight, you're obese, lose weight. How do you lose weight? It's very easy to say lose weight. Okay, so first thing is have a very balanced diet. Include more of roughage. No, reduce your calories, reduce your carbohydrates, and make sure you exercise. Don't eat leftovers. That's the first thing. As women, as moms, we do. That's the first thing we do. You know, whatever your child is left, you have to eat it. Whatever your husband is left, you have to eat it. No, that's very wrong. It's okay to throw something. I mean, it's not nice to throw food away. I know all of us feel that. Okay, but it's not nice to dump it in your stomach also. So don't eat leftovers. Eat a healthy diet. Include fruits in your diet. Include salads in your diet. Okay. Drink 3 to 4 liters of water every day. Okay. Whether you're working, keep an alarm in your mobile and drink water. Okay. That's the most important thing. And avoid alcohol. Exercise regularly. We already discussed the burden of cancer cervix. But the fun part about cervical cancer is, see, most cancers have so many things, genetic, the lifestyle, obesity, so many things. But you know, the best part about cervical cancer is it is caused by a virus. Okay? 99.7% of the times it is caused by a virus. And this virus comes by sexual exposure. Okay? I don't mean different partner sexual exposure, it comes by anybody who is into sexual activity are exposed to having this virus. Okay, so this is the human papilloma virus which causes cervical cancer. And this slide. So there are different types of HPV viruses. The most common is the type 16 and 18, which causes cancer cervix. Okay, now why is madam telling so much about these viruses? You know, it's not going to register in our brain anyway. You know, why I'm telling you this? Because the prevention of the cancer is related to these viruses. There is a vaccine to prevent the cancer. So that vaccine acts on these viruses. Okay? So what are the risk factors? Who are the ones who are at risk to get cervical cancer? If you've had a very early marriage, you know, you get into sexual activity early. If you've had early childbirths, frequent multiple childbirths, okay, and if there are multiple sexual partners, these are the people who are at high risk for getting cervical cancer. Okay, I'm seeing some faces amazed. Okay, doesn't mean all of you, because I know the trend here is to have a marriage early, over here, but doesn't mean you're all going to get cancer. Okay, so these are the risk factors. And taking contraceptive pills for a long time is also a risk for cervical cancer. Okay. So what are the alarm symptoms of cervical cancer? Since we are talking about prevention, you should know what cervical cancer causes. You know, what is the symptoms you are going to have?
So if you're having a persistent vaginal infection, if you're having bleeding, you know, in between your periods, if you're having bleeding, or after having sexual activity, if you're having any kind of spotting bleeding, okay, those are alarming symptoms. You must approach your doctor immediately. Suppose you're having repeated vaginal infections, wide discharge, repeated wide discharge, and it's not going, you're short, you know, you've taken many antibiotics, but still it's not going. So that could be one of the reason why such a thing is happening. So you must approach your doctor immediately. If anything abnormal in the pap test, your doctor will tell you how to proceed further. The other test is HPV testing. That is, we test for the virus in your smear cells, you know. The same pap test that we do, in the same smear cells, we can also test whether you are infected by the human papilloma virus. But suppose somebody is infected by the virus, does it mean that you're going to get cancer? Again, no. Okay? So I'm sure most of you think this madam is talking very controversial. Okay? But if, see, HPV causes the cancer, but doesn't mean that everybody infected with HPV gets cancer. Okay? So how frequently you should get a pap test? Okay? Under 21 years of age, a pap test is not needed. Okay, between 21 and 30 years of age, a pap test should be done every 3 years. Suppose it's negative, every 3 years you get a pap test. 30 and 65 years of age, you get a pap test every 3 years, or you can do a co-testing. That is, you do a pap test and a HPV test every 5 years. Okay? If you're 65 years and older and you've already, you know, had all negative pap tests, then you don't need any further screen. Alright? So I told you that there are vaccines available. The two types of vaccines are Gardasil and Cervarix. Now why am I telling you the names? Because these are the only two vaccines available and you must know them. Because you cannot take Gardasil vaccine once and take Cervarix vaccine again next time. Okay? So the Gardasil is a vaccine which caters to many strains of the virus, and Cervarix is very specific for cancer cervix vaccine. Okay. Now how the recommended dose is, Gardasil is taken at 0 month, 2 months and 6 months. The 0 month, 2nd month and the 6th month. Okay. And if you go for a Cervarix vaccine, it is 0, 1st month, 6th month. Okay, there is just a little difference there. Okay. Now who should take this vaccine? When can we give this vaccine? Okay, this vaccine is ideally recommended to girls before they actually, you know, enter in this, before they become sexually active. So as per our guidelines, we have certain groups, you know. So they guide between 9 and 45 years of age, but ideally before a girl becomes sexually active, it is ideal to give the vaccine. Between 9 to 15 years, only 2 doses are sufficient. Suppose you miss giving your vaccine to your daughter at that time, you can give it after 15 years, but at that time you give a full dose. That is 0, 1 and 6 or 0, 2 and 6. All the 3 doses. Alright? And I think most of you may ask me that, okay, cannot we take, I'm 30, I'm 35, whatever. So you can also take, get your pap test done. If it's negative, you can also take the vaccine. At least it will protect you from further exposure. Okay, so up to 45 years of age, you can take the vaccine. But when it comes to your daughters and, you know, your friends, sisters, whatever, ideally before they set into sexual activity, you can give them the vaccine. Okay, and there are certain special groups. Many people think whether it is safe in pregnancy or no to take such a vaccine and all. So generally avoid taking this vaccine in pregnancy because there are no studies based on that. If at all you have already taken one vaccine, one dose and you got pregnant, you tell them to complete the schedule after the delivery. Okay, lactating women can also take Gardasil vaccine. The next thing is how costly. Vaccines are very expensive. I'm sure all of you know vaccines are very expensive. Okay, this vaccine is not very expensive, but compared to what you would, you know, give to your daughters for all her cosmetics and for her marriage and dowry and stuff, this is going to be life saving. Okay, So don't think about the cost of the vaccine. Vaccinate your daughters immediately. Daughters, sisters, friends, whomever. Okay? So what are the preventive aspects that you must think in terms of cancer cervix is avoid early age at marriage. Okay? Next, multiparity. Avoid frequent childbirth. Spacing of childbirth is very important. Okay? Avoid multiple partners. You need to educate. You know, lot of you have teenage girls in your classes. Some of you must be having. So you have to educate them. You know, the maybe we'll take another session with madam's permission on sex education and menstrual hygiene also. But you got to educate them in some way. I mean, you all know best how you should do it. Okay, so you must do that. Improve nutrition, personal hygiene. Prevent smoking, alcohol, regular exercise, blah blah. Again, madam is telling the same thing. Okay? So, the power, as I said, is in your hands. And today, standing before you, I urge you all, okay, to be a part of our initiative, learn, educate, and change lives. Okay? I hope I have tried to communicate what I wanted. Now, a little quiz for you all. Guess who is this?
Mumtaz.
Anybody knows Mumtaz's story?
Got some cancer, I
remember. Yeah, very true. She suffered from breast cancer at a very, very early age, at the age of 54. And she underwent 6 cycles of chemotherapy. She suffered a lot. And today she's 73, doing well. Okay? So, you have to identify in time so that it can be treated. Okay? I am doing it, all of us will do it. Okay? So I don't want any sad story like Sharmila Devi. None of us should be in that position. Okay. Now, if you have any questions, you can give your slip to my nursing superintendent Deepthi. I'm also giving you a handout. Okay. It's a sticker form. All of you, please stick it in your cupboard or somewhere where you see it, and that's going to remind you to do your self breast examination every month. And also regarding the cancer. Cervical cancer vaccination, when you should go for a pap test. Okay, maybe you can put your dates and get your pap test done regularly. Okay, so whether we have communicated what we tried to today, and whether you need any more sessions of this sort, please let us know what kind of topics you want to be discussed so that we can prepare for that also.
Just as ma'am said, I was a cancer patient. At the age of 20, when I was, I have undergone everything. When they opened, they have seen it has damaged my ovary and everything. So everything was removed. A lot many things which went off. As my father was a doctor, he tried his level best to keep it. But it's not there. It's okay. So I faced all it. It was my uterine cancer, malignant cells. I have undergone 10 times biopsy. So they were literally removing the layers, and finally I told, no more biopsy, stop this, because it's really, it was getting into my thing, no more biopsy. So when as he was this thing, he said, no, I have to see the slides, last time I want. I said, okay, fine, the last time. And he himself sat and he has seen it under the microscope. So continuously the malignant cells were getting formed, no control, injections also. So finally he came out and he said, one day we were having tea, so he said, you know, you are just the top of the volcano. At the age of 21, he said, what to be done now? Because he was perplexed, what to be done, because removing uterus, ovary, as well as there were many men's. Once they opened, ma'am, I cannot share all these things because then they will come to know this thing, means how she is surviving. My small intestine is basically, it was also damaged. So the repair work has been done and it is stitched in the abdominal walls. I would request ma'am not to share with anybody, please. Thank you. Okay, so it was a experience. I said, my father, cut the volcano. Remove it. If it is giving me some troubles, remove it. He said, are you sure? I said, yeah, I'm 100%. and there the journey starts. I was in human hormone for the last till 44 years. I used to take injection because, as you know, at that age, everything has been removed, so I cannot stand. In order to maintain, I used to have take every day. I used to take the injection. Finally, at the age of 44, I told no more injections. Give me no tablets. So my surgeon uncle said, okay, fine, chalo. In the meantime, I have undergone 4 surgeries, major surgeries. I am a person with 5 major surgeries. I'm not even complete, but complete. By myself, I'm living the life. So nothing to worry. Just go for it. Go for the checkups and everything. Living the life. Not like that. I go out, I go alone, and I come back to Karimnagar. I feel I'm at home. I'm at home. Today, presently, what I'm standing, I don't know next moment. So that time, Chairman Sir was doing some analysis, you know, for the MSc, this NLP session. And they were saying it, you see through time. I said, I can't see through time, I can see now time. Because I know I'm living the moments, right? So live the life, live the moments, don't get panic about it. Cancer is a beautiful thing, you know. We appreciate it. If you get cancer, also appreciate it. Yes or no, ma'am?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Fighters like you should be there.
No. I'm one thing. See, what happens this time, I'm sorry to say, these ladies, what do they say? Oh my God, I got cancer. Half dead there only. Fight it. I'm telling you nothing. It's just as ma'am said, it's a multiplication of cells. Those who are science students, they will understand. So if you have the spirit, live it. Live the moments. And just do the thing. So ma'am, everybody raise their hand for the breast cancer. I was keeping it down. So last year also, when you know, I was admitted, so they asked a cancer patient, so we have to check the cancer. I said, don't dig in many things. You know, I believe few things in my life. Old house, old car, and old body should not be touched. The more you touch, you will get into the problems and it will go on. So it's better not to touch. But it was required and they touched, they got few things. I said, no, I have to walk, I have to live my life. So I'm doing with my all this. Prasuna ma'am, Rashmita ma'am, Anukar sir, Chairman sir. It's really something different. And my whole ex-Brigan hooligans. And my lovely kids. I just want to share one more thing. Happy Children's Day. Riyanshi came, I asked, do you love Exporica or me? Riyanshi turned, no ma'am, I love you. Sipa ma'am, I love you. So that was my achievement. They are my life, really. They are my life. Don't do it like this way, live the life, right? Thank you, God bless you all.
Thank you. Session which will indeed help us to live a better and healthy life. Now I request Madam Prasuna to share her inputs on this.
Good evening to all.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, Dr. Mrs. Sangeeta Reddy and team. Good evening once again. Really, it is presented by Mrs. Jigya and Mrs. Geeta. Really, it is a wonderful opportunity to learn so many things. Sometimes we'll read in the magazines and papers. First we'll read it and leave it. But by reading and following certain things and which information told by doctors, really we have to follow it. And this is the time to open our eyes. At least few certain things, if we follow, we can save our lives. After getting something, crying and disturbing the families, instead of that, if we aware of this, all this program, and prevent these things, it's better.
So we had one of the endocrinologists who left from Karimnagar. He was a very good endocrinologist. So he had his sister antenatal checkups at our place, and she was an elderly lady, got first time pregnant, and after she delivered the baby, she maybe within few days she came to us with some lump in the breast. So we were just suspected, we were suspecting something with the clot of milk and all that. So we gave her antibiotics, then again she came, it still even increased. Then we sent her for breast sonogram, and then we took fine needle aspiration. We found malignant cells in there. Then she was referred to oncosurgeon. Of course now she is doing well. So yeah, most of us, most of the doctors, we ourselves tend to mistake it to be some breast abscess. Yeah, anything, any lump, anything. So as Dr. Jigna said, initially you, maybe it's always better if it's possible you go to the doctor once, get your breast examined, then you know what it, then you yourself examine after going home. You get to know what is normal, what is not. Then every month when you are examining, was it similar to the last examination, you will be knowing about that. Any deviation from that means it's abnormal. And one more thing is nipple discharge. People tend to have nipple discharge, sometimes watery discharge for some other reasons. Please don't worry all the nipple about all the nipple discharges. So usually watery discharge is due to some people tend to have their prolactin levels high. So the doctor examines your prolactin, if it's high, mostly it's due to that. So as she said, if it's yellow color, it's, if it is purulent, if it is pus-like or if it is bloody, then there is a suspicion. So anything, don't worry. What, as Ms. Chemister said, see, be bold, be brave, we can fight the cancer. Okay, thank you. Yeah, I think that itself is a big topic. Big topic. Exercise is, see, one thing is doing our own job, like in the West they do, because they can't afford for a maid. So here, since we can afford a maid, we are dependent on our maids. So I think it's, if you can adapt to that lifestyle, it's always better. You can do on your own. It's not a big thing. Only thing is you need some of your husband's help. That is one thing. And the next thing is walking better? So usually what people say, what the who are into this health consciousness and who are into this exercise mode, they say walking, don't do much of walking. So the more walking you do, I'll reduce my weight and I would like to walk. No, even I thought this like this about 1 year back, but I got some knowledge through some fine lovely apps like Fitter, FITTR. If you would like to go on Facebook also, there's one Fitter page and Fitter app, you can download that. There's wealth of knowledge about how to take care of your body, which is not there even in our textbooks. So walking, and it's not that ideal, but yes, daily at least 5 to 10,000 steps are needed. So actually those who are working at home and all, maybe they'll put in around 10,000 steps. But people, we, you and we, all of us have sedentary lifestyle. So it's always better to put some steps, but don't do too much of walking. That will lead to your muscle wasting. So if you're going into muscle wasting, it's not healthy. And the more muscle is gone, your BMR becomes low. So whatever little food you're eating, it gets converted into fat. So apart from gym, weight training is the best, they say. Mostly weight training is the best. Next is maybe aerobics, and all these come under cardio. Walking, aerobics, swimming, dancing, everything. So at least do something. So even gym can be done at home. Even home workouts, would, I think most of the channels on YouTube are showing even that. So see what is good in YouTube. So try to adapt the lifestyle. No, no. As you said, as I said just now, all the nipple discharges are not breast cancer. So, if you are hypothyroid, probably you must, your prolactin level must have raised, your prolactin levels are raised, I think. So, please check your prolactin levels once. If they are raised, you have to, or you need to consult the doctor, or an endocrinologist or a gynecologist. So if you are hypothyroid, most there's a relation between thyroid, low thyroid levels and high prolactin levels. So if it's hypothyroid, sometimes they tend to have higher prolactin levels, which is related to lactation and all. So it could be that discharge, don't worry. But at the same time, show it to doctor once.
So we all are fighting the cancer.
Yeah.